everyone. This is Bishop Strawn from LifeGate Christian Ministries in Abaco. Not the type person to ever come out and talk very much about what's happening or make any political statement, as many of you would be aware of. But I had to come on today because I am very upset and very angry of the misinformation that has been sent out to the Bahamian people, of persons who had no idea of the hell that we went through in Abaco. I lost my home, but came out with only the clothes on my back, as many Abaconians have. And the truth of the matter is that there is no gas stations in Marsh Harbor. There is no port. There is no power. The power grid, and I've worked to BPL for over 25 years, the power grid and the distribution system in Marsh Harbor has totally been destroyed. And so the hopes of restoring power anytime soon there is impossible. There is no food stores. There is no hardware stores. There are no banks. The only thing that we did to survive over the last several days was scavenge through food stores, trying to pick up tuna fish cans or corned beef cans or water and whatnot. And there is no help. I am very frustrated and upset at the government because we received no help. Thank God for the Americans that came in through Treasure Key, bringing plane loads of stuff after stuff. Now I've been made to understand that our government has stopped the planes from coming in, and only God knows how those persons are gonna get any kind of help or supplies. You could not even get on Bahamas Air. We paid $75. My son, my wife, and my youngest boy, my son, my wife, and myself, $75 per person, or Bahamas Air was not allowing you to get on the plane. Thank God for Western Air that came to deliver some stuff, and they decided that they were going to carry as much people as they can, and they did it for free. They did it for free. And our government had Bahamas Air charge us $75 to get over here in the Bahamas. My God. Something is definitely wrong with that. Most of the churches are destroyed. Treasure Key is destroyed. And there are people who are in Abaco that may not have been affected as badly as we have been in central Abaco. And the people in South Abaco has not been affected as badly as we've been. That they don't have any idea how terrible it is. The stench of dead body is unbelievable. There will be an outbreak of epidemic at some point. There is all kind of problems with keeping law and order in there. There are hardly any church left. Thank God our church was one of the few that is still standing. But it is unbelievable to me that lies would be said. And I am not political. I don't play the political game, but as far as I'm concerned, I'm a Bahamian, and if it's one thing that we should be all about is looking after Bahamians, and I'm frustrated and extremely angry about what is going on. If anybody have family members in Abaco, I'm telling you now, get them out by whatever means necessary. I'm glad that most of our persons are out of Abaco from our church, and I'm hoping that the rest can come out shortly. We have to regroup, and we have to get back in there to carry as much things that we can, water, food, supplies, whatever else we need. The bridge to Abaco connecting Little Abaco to mainland has been destroyed. Even they've been having some difficulties getting from Cooperstown into Treasure Key area. My wife and I had to stay in a car for several hours while we watched our house tumble down in the front of us, and we had to dash to another house and spend 7 to 8 hours to 220 plus miles per hour winds, just holding and praying on for dear life. And we spent the night in the car. Thank God for one of our neighbors who came over and took us in and gave us a dry place. The only thing we left Abaco with was the clothes on our bodies and our passports. And thank God we had our passports, because if we didn't have the passports and if we didn't have the $75 per person to pay to get off the island, we would have still been on the island today. I don't understand that for the life of me. I don't know who's listening, but I hope the whole of the Bahamas is, and I pray that all those who are listening to me will share the video as much as they can. Sandy Point, South Abaco, if you can hear me, there's nothing in Marsh Harbor, nothing there to support you. North Abaco, if you could hear me, there's nothing there to support you. I just got a hot meal for the first time in 5 days when I landed here last night after being in Treasure Key from 8-9 o'clock in the morning, standing on the line with a whole lot of people, hundreds and hundreds of people, all trying to get on the plane, only to find out from Bahamas Air that we had to pay to get out. Thank God for Western Air. Thank God for Western Air. I don't know who owns Western Air, but sir, may the blessings of the Lord be on you and your company for reaching out. You didn't have to load the planes up with people to get them out, but you were there, and we give God praise and glory for you, sir. I pray, and again, let me end by saying, I am not political. I never subscribe to political parties. Anybody that knows me well enough that they've never seen a PLP or FNM flag on my car, on my clothes. I've never attended any of the rallies. I do my best to stay neutral because as far as I'm concerned, I must reach all men and all women at all times. It's all about souls. But I am very upset about what took place. And I hope and pray that the government will change its course and do whatever they can to get our people, our Abaconians, off the island as soon as possible. God bless you. And I pray if you have any means of getting stuff to Abaco, please, water, food, whatever you can, do whatever you can. But most of all, please try and help our Abaconians to get off as quickly as possible. God bless you, and we are praying for you.